Welcome to e-lecture series for BTech 6M, subject Artificial Intelligence. Myself Prakash Meena, Assistant Professor Computer Science and Engineering from Engineering College Ajmer. Today's topic is Probabilistic Reasoning, Bayesian Network. Here we only define the Bayesian networks, so we give a definition about it. Not detail about Bayesian network. So first we have to recall from our previous lecture the basic element of probability theory and noted the importance of independence and conditional independence relationships in simplifying probabilistic representation of world, and a systematic way to represent such relationships explicitly in the form of Bayesian networks. We will not discuss about syntax and semantics of the network, but here we just give some definition about it. So after if we have time, then we will discuss about syntax and semantics of Bayesian networks. So first, already we saw that the full joint probability distribution can answer any question about the domain, but can become intractably large as the number of variable grows. So furthermore, specifying probabilities for possible worlds one by one is unnatural and tedious. So also saw the independence of conditional independence relationship among variable can greatly reduce the number of probabilities that need to be specified in order to define the full joint distributions. And here a data structure called Bayesian networks to represent the dependencies among variables, and Bayesian networks can represent essential any full joint probability distribution, and in many cases can do so very concisely. Then basic definition. So Bayesian network is a directed graph in which each node is annotated with quantitative probability information. The full specification is as follows. First, each node corresponds to a random variable which may be discrete or continuous. Second, a set of directed links or arrows connects pairs of nodes. If there is an arrow from node X to node Y, then X is said to be parent of Y. The graph has no directed cycle and hence there is a directed acyclic graph or DAG. And then third, each node XI has a conditional probability distribution PXI given parents XI that quantifies the effect of the patterns parents on the node. Then the topology of the networks, the set of nodes and links specifies the conditional independence relationship that holds in the domain in a way that will be made precise shortly. And the intuitive meaning of an arrow is typically that X has a directed influence on Y, which suggests that causes should be parents of effects. It is usually easy for a domain expert to decide what direct influences exist in the domain, and in fact that then actually specifying the probabilities themselves. And once the topology of the Bayesian network is laid out, we need only specify a conditional probability distribution for each variable and given its parents. And we will see that the combination of the topology and the conditional distribution suffices to specify the full joint distribution of all the variables. So again, recall the simple world earlier we described. So here is the figure consisting of the variable toothache, cavity, catch and weather, and we argued that weather is independent of the other variables, and furthermore we argued that toothache and catch are conditionally independent. And given cavity, these relationships are represented by the Bayesian network structure. So you can see here in diagram a simple Bayesian network in which weather is independent of the other three variables and toothache and catch are conditionally independent given cavity. So the conditional independence of toothache and catch given cavity is indicated by the absence of a link between toothache and catch. Intuitively, the network represents the fact that cavity is a direct cause of the toothache and catch, and whereas no direct causal relationship exists between toothache and catch. So now consider a example which is just a little more complex here. You have a new burglar alarm installed at home, and it is fairly reliable at detecting a burglary, but also respond on occasion to minor earthquakes. So you also have two neighbors, John and Mary, who have promised to call you at work when they hear the alarm. So John nearly always calls when he hears the alarm, but sometimes confuses the telephone ringing with the alarm and call then too. And Mary on the other hand likes the rather loud music and often misses the alarm altogether. Given the evidence of who has or has not called, we would like to estimate the probability of a burglary. So a Bayesian network for this domain appears in figure as you can see here, and the network structure shows that burglary and earthquakes directly affects the probability of the alarms going off. But whether John and Mary call depends only on the alarm. The network thus represents our assumptions that they do not perceive burglaries directly, they do not notice minor earthquakes, and they do not confer before calling. And the conditional distributions, as you can see here, shown as a conditional probability table or CPT. Okay, and each row in a CPT contains the conditional probability of each node value for a conditioning case, and a conditioning case is just a possible combination of values for the parent nodes, a miniature possible world. And each row must sum to 1 because the entries represents an exhaustive set of cases for the variable. For Boolean variable, once you know that the probability of a true value is p, the probability of false must be 1 minus p. So we often omit the second number as in figure you can see. And in general, a table for a Boolean variable with k Boolean parents contain 2 the power k independently specifiable probabilities, and a node with no parents has only one row representing the prior probabilities of each possible value of the variable. So here we define a Bayesian network, and there are 2 examples, so you can understand how the Bayesian network works, and there are conditional probabilities table and conditioning case also. So all our material are from artificial intelligence, a modern approach, 3rd edition. So you can refer this text for more info. So session ended here. Thank you.